wants to work in a salon in the future? And have answers to our questions that we've always had through this.
Yes.
Also, if you're a consumer, right? If you're a consumer and you feel that it's your right to purchase and professional hair care products from your salon also online, great for you to sign the petition as well.
Yes. And the link, if you guys want to know, it is in the bio of this, of Madoma's Instagram. So you can click the link right there and sign up through there.
Yes, I'm not sure if it's right there, but we will make sure it's back as soon as we have this live feed over. So people have, it's easy for people then to just click on that and then sign the petition. And it's important, people.
It is important, but you guys assume that everyone who's tuning in so far today knows what we're talking about. So
true story.
There is a, we always like to kind of recap the previous week, but we can't assume that you know what we're talking about if this is your first time tuning in. So really quickly, it's about professional salons being able to sell their professional products on their professional private website, so that clients of the establishment have a safe place to buy legitimate product, as opposed to just going to a search engine and finding it somewhere in a shop, not knowing where it comes from, if it's been watered down, if it's even supposed to be in this country because of all of the rules coming in and out. Some products that are sold in Europe and sold here, for instance, need to be adjusted by this country's standards. Mm-hmm. So we just want to make sure that it is an option. No questions asked. The product that we have here on the shelf can also be bought online by our clients. And a lot of companies have said that that's a big no-no, but we haven't been able to get a straight answer. So they need to come around. Like a lot of things that are outdated, I know there are people shaking their heads right now saying, oh yeah, I know, this is outdated, that's outdated. At one point we're gonna talk about the cosmetology test, which just has not been reworked. So there are certain things that are in place that I know that some people in the offices who have said it's just too much paperwork to change it, and we can't use that, we can't settle for that. So there are a lot of people in all of the fields that would love to be advocates and speak on those causes, that there's so many things that we could be fighting for, right?
Improving the standards.
And this is something really simple.
Improving the standards of the hairdressing industry. That's what this is really all about. It's part of it.
Yes.
Right.
I mean, we got a visit last week from a company that's pretty big out there, and was letting us know that actually they're starting to do that and actually supporting salons by letting them sell on their websites.
Right,
and
so without giving away the company or the specifics.
Yes.
We're always looking to each other, right? That's what we are using this as an extension for, building our community and reaching more of you. To learn from. Maybe she came in because of that, I'm not sure.
I'm not sure.
But she offered up timely information, right, that we were asking.
And
she said,
interesting.
Yeah, basically, if you carry the product line, they allow you to sell the product line on your site, and it gets even better that it comes direct from where our product would come from. So there's no expense in shipping or any of that on us. We don't collect the price of the product, but they do give you a portion of that sale because of representing and being a product supporter within your establishment. So that's the first person who walked through the door that said they were offering anything that sounded like an interesting idea. So
a pro salon, pro salon policy. That also protects the manufacturers.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly. And so, I mean, one of our other reps that, you know, is helping us out, I see that you joined on here, James.
Yay.
Oh, James! James! So he's even out there looking for answers, too, he's a big supporter of ours, so I appreciate that, and I see you're on here. Thank you for joining.
Yes, always big support. We need big supporters.
Okay, so that is and tried so hard to create our community
from there.
And we're both from European homes, Michael and myself, and it was important for us to kind of break bread with everyone who wanted to come in and say hello and listen to our community there. When you move to Midtown in a crazy city, you feel, it was hard enough on the ground floor. It was hard enough on the ground floor there, but we're still, you know, give shout outs to our favorite go-tos like Canyon Road on First Avenue, Roberto and his team there. And we sent so many people to that restaurant because the food was consistent and the staff was fun. And the chef and management, now owner, just were so kind and really cared about each person at their tables enjoying themselves, enjoying the meal, enjoying the moment. It's very reasonable by New York standards. This is somewhere you can take your family. There are full families in there. But we sent so many people. There were a couple of times where we walked in when we were working there, and I would hear, Mariana, Mariana, Mariana.
It's like a part of the family there.
Yeah, and it's nice to create that, and it's nice also when we're invited in and people say, hey, you know, we're doing this reading. We would love for you to come. We're, you know, whatever it is, when people reach out to us, it's not always us doing. We enjoy it, and it's kind of, you know,
sure.
who wins,
that's
right?
What,
both sides.
That's what
win.
I wanted to say. If we find out about something that we really enjoy, we appreciate, we feel that
it's passionate.
We have to let people know. We share by nature. It's within us. And we can help ourselves.
Yeah, and appreciate those who do the same.
And appreciate those who do the same. But we also came across, interestingly enough, right, when it comes to salons,
mm-hmm.
To stylists and services, that some clients seem to be going down the route of, I want to keep it a secret, so my stylist is not getting too popular, and I'm not getting an appointment anymore. So I would say that is an interesting idea, but we want you to share us just like we share everything else that we love to share. So don't keep it a secret.
Yeah.
Tell people, recommend, refer. It's very important, especially in your neighborhood, even more so.
And
well,
I'm sure your stylist will always have time.
Yeah, that's what I say. Like, especially here at Montana, we always accommodate.
Yes.
You know, sometimes the hours are 12 to 8 during the week, but I know Michael last week was here after 8 o'clock to help our clients. So we do what we can for you guys.
Well ahead.
Within reason.
Within reason, we have lines, right?
There are times when you do need to speak.
Yeah.
But, you know, it is better to be busy than not to be busy, because you know what? It keeps us creative. You know, if I'm just sitting here not doing stuff, and I feel, you know, my creativity is being wasted. It's not being shared.
Right.
So, you know, in order to grow, that's what I have to do, is work with
more people. Well, any of us. It's like our designers and our artists. Everybody gets a dry spell, you know. But share. That helps. It just helps your community. It helps support the people that you love.
Yeah.
Going back to our old neighborhood, I have to give a shout out to my other buddies at Vinocchio.
Oh, Vinocchio was, yes, a great neighborhood.
Our team
fun.
Up there, oh my gosh. They came in shortly after we were in up there, and we still, I don't get down there much, boys, but I think of you often, and I wish I could drag myself down those blocks to get to you some days, but sometimes I stay in my pajamas until, you know, 9:30 p.m. doing
was
people.
Was it Pinocchio's on York Avenue?
Pinocchio's on York Avenue.
And 76.
Yes, so if you're on the Upper East Side, please go tell the boys that Mariana and Michael and Midoma said that. We should go in and say hi.
Great neighborhood coffee
shop. Great neighborhood coffee shop. And I stopped in a couple of weeks ago, and they had some music thing, and it seemed like an impromptu thing going on. And I know they have a piano. I don't know if they have it all the time. They at one time brought in a piano. Again, I haven't been there in a long time. We've been in this location for 8.5 years. But it's a really, it feels like something out of my Hallmark movies when you walk into Pinocchio, you know? It just feels small town, fast paced, but small town, you walk in and they have a really great thing going. shout out to someone who has been here practically the same time that we've been here, whose acquaintance we just made what seems to be like just months ago, right?
Yeah,
I think
yeah,
it may
yeah.
have been earlier this year. Orietta Pispino. And would you hold my drink? My cup. Orietta has this amazing, it's a nonprofit theater just 2 blocks from here. 2 blocks from here?
Nonprofit theater,
yeah.
Yes. Along the corner, basically.
And my math is just, I got
just
a bunch of numbers confusing my
for everyone who doesn't know where that's at.
Yes. So, I'm gonna show you about this. So, here's her studio, Theater Lab. They have studio rentals. They produce things as well. They have, I guess, 3 different spaces within her floor to accommodate different types of different scopes of work. Although she has been heard to say quite often that she loves the physicality of production. So keep that in mind. If you have lots of physicality in what you want to perform, this may be a place that you want to check out, all my theater friends. So I don't know how close I can get, but I don't know. Let's see.
Here, like this for you.
Yeah, I can't tell you.
So there you go.
Delay. The other left. Those are the rooms.
Amazing little independent theater in the heart.
Who has this amazing new brochure? I got this from Orietta, right?
In the
heart very proud.
Of the district.
And full season they had. We've got to see a couple of these. I've gone there even for a reading. This is one side of their brochure. And you can pick one up. I'm sure if you call in or write in, I'm sure it's all on the website, right? But if you want one of these guys to keep it in your bag, like I always keep mine, so I can tell people what's going on there, they do have it now. So please, please, please support Orietta, her theater lab, and all of the amazing people that you can meet there. So I think that's important, being a performer and a theater person. I wanted to give my shout out to her, and I hope soon to bring her to you, whether we have to go there and do a split segment, or if we can get her in here one of these Tuesdays. I do want to bring other people to you as well. Who did you want to give a shout out to today?
Well, just around the corner around here, I mean, within the first, within 2 weeks of being here, Michael actually took me on a tour around the neighborhood, and right around the corner on 38th Street is Last Rites Gallery. I myself am very into the macabre and the creepy. May not look it right now, but of course now I have the beard, it might be creepy. But anyways, walking in there, it's a great space. They have weird art,
dark art.
And they have 2 floors in there, and they have artists come through, I think it's like about every couple months or so, which actually I know for sure next week they're going to be having their 10-year anniversary opening on Saturday, Saturday from 6 to 9.
Just in case, you can check them out, Last Rites Gallery, as in R-I-T-E-S.
That's right.
But what's interesting about this space also is that it functions as a tattoo parlor.
That's where it's
as well.
Yeah, downstairs underneath, it's basically the Haunted Mansion inside the decor down there where you're getting your tattoos done. So it's artists doing live art as well as paintings on the wall. So it's a really cool combined space, kind of like how we do.
Paul Booth.
His tattoo is on the second floor, tattoo area.
Reputable ink artist, right?
Yes,
feature.
Very reputable. They do a lot of realistic color, black and white. If you go to their website, you can definitely see it. It's super cool.
Yeah.
And Donya, who actually is one of their
curators.
Donya!
The only Donya you'll know. That's her Instagram, the only Donya you know. She's an artist herself. She does a lot of illustration work, and it's really cool because she animates her illustration work, which is cool too, on her site. So
she's the Mariana of Last Rites.
Yes.
Perfect.
That's exactly
what Last Rites. So speaking of concept, I is on 10. If you don't know them, get to know them. It's a great concept where everything revolves around the number 10, a cycle of 10. It's all about artists and their creations. And 10 artists, from what I gather,
10 weeks.
10%
to charities that they have chosen.
Also, yes.
When you purchase from them.
So each cycle stays up for 10 weeks, and then a whole new cycle starts. And I always describe that space a little bit more like a museum store.
That's a good way to say it.
When you go to the Met or you go to Guggenheim or MoMA museum store, that's kind of what you can expect.
Just not as cluttered.
However, what's great about them is that they're also very good because of their, maybe because of the 10 thing, right? Uh-huh. They have so many people involved that when we went there, we had told Joseph about it.
Yes.
He was there.
Of course.
And
he couldn't help it.
Kevin was there. And we walked in, and one of our jewelry designers, Michael Suzuki, mm-hmm. she was there. And one of our past designers,
fashion designer,
she was there.
Speaking of Heike Yarek, I'm sorry, before we forget, Heike Yarek, great fashion designer. Around the corner, her studio is around the corner. Heike Yarek, great fashion designer. So many people, we can't forget about
that. And we saw a couple that we hadn't seen since our old location. They were part of an event that we did.
Broken Artists?
Yes.
Greenpoint Artists?
Yes, so we want to give a shout out to Tal Photo.
Mm-hmm.
And who else was there? In this
space,
it was truly
area.
A homecoming.
Yeah.
We walked in there, and again, it was me being hugged and kissed and by all these people I haven't seen. So Maison 10 is very good at building that community, and it's kind of an extension of who we are. I don't think they've been doing this for 18 and a half years.
No. I think
but yet, a lot of other people were right there.
Cycle 11 or 12, and so, you know, take that by 10 weeks, so it's about two years, 3 years, I think, to the max. So, but it's a fresh concept, and we like it.
Yeah.
You know, we like different concept ideas, and that's a good one to check out.
Just on 29th Street, so right by the Empire State, if you ever know.
We'll put up a post with all neighbors mentioned and the handles, so
you
can
tag them there.
Check them out.
Tag them all, not just tag.
Yeah.
Tag them all.
Always get credit where credit's due, right?
That's right. Mm-hmm. Amen to that. Amen to that. Everybody works hard and everybody deserves to. We all should support. But you've got to give credit where credit is due, right? I think that's important.
Yes. But this is one way of how we can show support and keep the independent, small business world going.
And even if you're not completely a business yet. Yesterday, so this past Saturday night, after a completed day at work, we started filming our very special immigration project. And that was with one of our clients first, and then who became a fashion stylist. That's not how she started. And then, most important to me, she became a friend. And this woman has a huge heart, so I'm going to give a shout out to Nazia.
So
you'll be hearing, I don't need to tell you her story right now because that's what the immigration project is about.
Stylemeister
is her brand.
Is
so
important.
You can go to Stylemeister. This girl is funny, and she's talented, and she's sweet, and she's a woman's advocate. That's all we're going to say. I know.
Yeah, stay tuned to that.
But
she lives and breathes fashion.
Yes.
This is all I have to say.
Yes. And it would not have been able to happen if it wasn't for the professionalism, the planning, the patience, the p-p-p-p-s. Of Anthony, and I'm sorry because it's a newer relationship. Does he have a new how you handle yourself. I can't say enough things about you that, seriously, top notch, sir. Thank you. And then yesterday, we had a client who came up to support me when I was doing 42nd Street up in Hudson Valley, up in Chatham. And she has been acting over the last couple of years, and she's been writing, and she's been taking classes along with her job, which is pretty important, her day job that she's gone in and out of. She's an amazing person, Marianne Hardart, so I want to give you a big, huge shout out because I'm so proud of how far you've come in such a short time. So when I reach out to people like that, and I truly am inspired by how short of a time you can make achievements if you commit fully to something. You create those circles and you build off of that positive energy, and you don't get trapped under negative vibes. You go for it. You say, these people can help me. And I offered my space, and she was in here yesterday, and I can't wait to see something from that. All I saw was an image that someone shared and Michael shared with me, and it looked like you guys had an amazing time in this space yesterday. On Saturday, we had the pop-up shop that was Soraya Fashions. Check her out. She said she enjoyed the space and us so much that she wants to do a big event in January or February of this coming year. So again, we never ask for you to do anything that we are not doing ourselves.
They just open the door for you. That's it. All you guys are doing is just opening the door and giving someone a platform. That's so amazing.
Then you can.
Don't cry, Joseph.
I'm just telling you because, like, there are so many people out there that are for themselves, and just because we're so bogged down by the everyday mundane life that we have to do to make money to survive. And that should not be our only motivation to live, you know? With you guys, with art being a motivator and just having a heart being a motivator, it opens up doors for a lot more things to come, I feel. You know, there's more opportunity with it. There's more avenues you can go when there's heart involved rather than just a one-track mind of sales. So definitely, with having that platform, you guys open many doors.
If you're talented and if you are passionate, if you have something great to offer, and then you give it a platform, I think from there the sky is the limit.
Exactly.
Really
why
is.
Stop at the sky?
Let's go to the moon.
yeah, the platform. You know, maybe we can talk about the platform next week a little bit. What is the platform for a? What does it mean? What does Nigoma Salon mean? To be an artist here on this platform, if you're working with hair, or if you're working in fashion, or if you're working in beauty
art.
I think next week we should talk about that. What that entails.
Right, and the special guests portion of this. I'm really working to reach out to all of our artists and designers and neighbors and try to bring some of these pretty special people to you.
Live.
Live, yeah. Put them in the hot seat.
But it's 11 o'clock on Tuesday, and it's not that easy.
Not that easy. It's
but
not
sometimes,
that easy.
We were just talking last night, though, we might be able to go on location if you guys want to be a part of it, too.
Yeah.
Where we can do something where
simultaneously
yeah. being here. And
allow us our growing pains, please.
Yes.
You're all very kind.
This is a project in process, right?
Yes.
So we're growing
every
month. This is the fourth time we're doing this.
Yes, and last week we had a studio audience of one who then came to me over the weekend and said, you guys got a really fun thing going, and I think you can grow your studio audience. So upon hearing that, we then said, oh, well, that opens up for games and a whole bunch of things that we see from it. So you're all part of this from the ground up, and we are not trying to be YouTube sensations.
No.
We are not trying to be superstars. But we're trying to keep it real, and we're trying to put heart before anything else, and we're trying to support people who we find are inspiring. So to those of you out there who think you have something that would be an amazing fit for Midoma Fashion Art,
yes,
or
of course, we'd love to
please bring it. We'd love to share. So keep that in mind. I think we're at the end of our day here. It's 11:31.
Already?
Yes.
Already.
Time flies when you're having fun.
I hope you guys are enjoying this. Please send comments.
Please
ask questions. Please tell us topics that you want us to touch on. We try to introduce the next week at the end of this week. So I think we're going to continue a bit with the talking about our platform.
Yes.
And try to bring in some people one way or the other, whether you're here or you're there, to talk about their story. And really quickly, we want to say that this is the last week for Karen Chappell.
That's right.
Yes.
Comes down Friday night.
Hudson,
on Saturday,
Valley,
we have Vladimir coming in with art and jewelry. And we have the opening next Thursday from 6 to 8 p.m. $5 gets you in. And what an amazing time we have at those openings. They're pretty comical, I must say, and a little artist talk. And we are also bringing Paul Carroll, who is pretty much a staple with us over the last 6-7 years. We're bringing him back in with his fall fashions.
Brand new fashion.
So we're looking forward to John and Paul walking through the door with all the Paul Carroll
amazing
stuff next
New York
week.
City fashion, yes.
And he will be here also next Thursday, 6 to 8 p.m. So on that note, we bid you adieu. And
also, I wanted to say, as always, this talk will be available on our YouTube channel. And how to get there, just go to midoma.com on the news page, and there you can replay what we've talked about today, because not everybody can really tune in live.
No.
That's right.
And if you're missing anything too right now, you can always watch again just to change. Right?
Yeah.
Well, clients are going to be coming in, so we're going to get going.
Yep. So I heart all of you, and if I knew how to do that, I would.
Let's do some.
Let's do this.
So heart.